when you scale, do it fast. Hello, good afternoon. Welcome to Airbus.
Thank you. Are you ready to take off the pack?
Absolutely. Follow me. Welcome to the pack. Each card is a new question. Give us your best answer. Let's begin. Okay, c'est parti. Is the world moving too fast on AI? I don't think this is the right question. The world is moving anyway, so we need to keep the pace. What's been the most surprising impact of AI? There are two things for me that are really striking. One is the speed of the development. It takes 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, even 10 years sometimes before you are completely finished. Here we are more talking about projects that you can deliver within the year. The second thing is the return on investment. The multiples we are seeing in this kind of project, I have never seen them in any other kind of project in 34 years of digital work. What's the biggest adoption roadblock to AI? Airbus is one 145,000 employees and companies. It's a lot of work to train, to educate, to make sure that people understand AI and how this will change the way they work. We cannot afford to leave people on the road. How is AI changing the passenger experience? No, I don't think this one.
There you go. Round two, quickfire.
Classical or jazz? Rock. Tea, coffee. Dance or sing? None of them. Decision-making or factory floor? Decision-making. Late nights or early mornings? Both. Votre fromage préféré? Saint-Nectaire. What's a digital gift that keeps on giving? Cyber attacks? Do you get to go on test flights? I'm not allowed to. In a more efficient world, what do we do with our free time? We meet with friends, we drink a couple of glass of wine, we talk about sports, weather, and nice things. What will always need humans? I hope decision-making will always be done by you, but I'm not sure of that. Have you ever Googled yourself? Yes, 4 years ago. Round complete.
Hey!
What's your favorite Airbus AI use case? The favorite one is an AI that we have built to support the workers, where we are doing the junction between the fuselage and the wings. It's a very complex operation, and we have built, thanks to computer vision, combined with modeling, combined with historical data, the tools that help the team to perform that operation. They can do it quicker, they can do it safer, also more effectively. So I think it's my favorite one for the moment. But I'm sure that it will be surpassed by others in the future. How should organizations build AI for the long term? I think the most important thing will be to build trustworthy AI. AI that we can trust, that the users can trust, that the authorities can trust. So for me, the trustworthy AI is what we need to do. Does AI work better for specialists or across a whole organization? I think it works for both. We will have the embedded AI, so which will come with the software that you use. Then there will be, for example, AI assistant for lawyers, AI assistant for procurement. Then there will be built AI, so homemade AI on the topics that are the most critical, or made by engineers from Airbus. When you assemble all this AI together, you will serve the entire company. So it will work for specialists, it will work for anybody in his daily tasks. What advice would you give to other companies as they implement AI? I would say start small. You don't know what will work and what will not work. And then think big. So once you have something that is working, really think on how you will scale it. And when you scale, do it fast. You have worked in a range of sectors. Who is leading the AI race? I think automotive is quite advanced. Space industry is quite advanced. And that's one of the places in Airbus where it started 30 years ago. We were doing the first AI models on satellite imagery interpretation. So I would say, yeah, space, automotive industry, and then, of course, digital industry. What will aerospace look like tomorrow? I don't know, and that's what is exciting. This is the end.